Well, it kind of goes without saying, this whole time right now, all the COVID-19, you hear the news, you see statistics, your eyes go cross-eyed. The whole thing can be soul-crushing, emotionally just meh. Well, the question is, despite this crisis, how do we let the people that are special in our lives know how much they are loved, how much they are celebrated? Our next guest has found a simple way to do just that and to put the priorities where they belong.
That's right, Sean. We're really looking forward to this. Debbie Ronka joins us this morning from Texas. She's the president of Sequoia Coaching. She's also a best-selling author. Debbie, great to have you on the show. Good morning to you.
Good morning, JJ. Good morning, Sean.
It's great to have you.
Wonderful to be here with you today.
Absolutely. You are shining bright, my dear. Tell us all about the family letter.
Oh, Sean, I loved how you opened up about, especially being in this time with the family letter. This is a tool that we've used in our family for over 30 years now, where we're intentional about sharing with our family members what we love, value, and celebrate about them. And we do it through the simple tool of a letter. So what's so powerful is that now we can do this during this time where we've all been asking for more family time, and now we have it. And so I would love to share with all of the viewers what we've done in our family. Basically, it's a letter that we've chosen to write on our birthdays. And how I help my readers, I have a template in the book with guidelines, because I think it's difficult for some people to just come up with what is the best thing to put in the letter. Yeah. So here's some guidelines for everyone. Number one, we tell the person why we love them, not just that we love them, but specifically why, because that will go deeper. We celebrate the gifts and the talents that each person has, because they, whether it's in sports, music, leadership in the community, we recognize what characteristics they have, like their sense of humor, compassion, different things like that, because you want to recognize and celebrate who that person is. Yeah. You want to recognize maybe different seasons that they're walking through. Say they're going from high school to college. Maybe they're about to get married. Maybe they're about to have a new baby. There's different seasons in life. So we also pen this in our letters. And, you know, all of us experience a difficult time in life where we walk through a trial, difficulties, and we also write in the letters how we saw that person walk through it with courage and tell them how proud we were of them and how they got to the other side. So by the time you're done reading these letters, you really know that you're known, loved, valued, and celebrated. Yeah. And what I help people with is we've chosen as a family to do this on our birthdays. And what better day to be celebrated is on your birthday. Mm-hmm. So every birthday within my family, we each receive a letter. So say it's my birthday. My husband and my three children each write their own letter to me based on the guidelines that I just shared. And then we sit around our table and I read each letter out loud. So everyone gets to hear what everyone else has written. And I'll tell you, Sean and JJ, that just creates such bonding and connecting, and you wind up sharing more stories, and you're laughing, you're crying, and everybody feels valued, loved, and celebrated. Now you know how the other person really feels about you, and you can't help but draw closer and strengthen a family as a result.
Well, it creates a human connection. It's not, you know, the hustle and bustle, things can kind of get lost in the mix. So this kind of forces you to have that human connection and to realize, you know, the person across from you cares about you and vice versa. There's the family letter, and then there's legacy letters and the last letter. Explain what those are.
Legacy letters are for the grandparents. We as parents are busy raising children. Grandparents are more overseers, observers, and they can see things in grandchildren that sometimes maybe the parents miss. And how powerful to receive a letter from your grandparent when you're graduating, your birthday, special times in life, your grandparent telling that grandchild what value and purpose they see in them. Grandchildren lean on the words of their grandparents, so it's a very powerful tool. The last letter actually came about years ago when my father was passing away from cancer. My children were young at the time, and they all asked if they could write their grandfather a letter. And it was such a tender and sacred time. We took their letters and we stood around my father's hospital bed and we read them out loud so my father could hear them. And I know my father could hear the words. I could tell by the countenance on his face. And he just left this world knowing the impact that he had on my children. And out of that, Sean and JJ, I thought, what gift could I leave my family? And so both my husband and I have decided we're going to have our last letters written, kept with our wills, so that when we're gone, our children and family members will have our last and final words of love and encouragement. Because when you grieve, what is the one thing that you want? You want to hear the words of the loved one that's no longer with you.
Yeah.
And so that's what the last letter is all about.
Well, Debbie, I want to thank you very much because you've officially just made me cry on TV.
Made
so thank
cry,
you for that.
Debbie.
It's really, really, truly touching. I think right now, especially, you know, with everything that's going on, you're kind of just cutting through all the traffic and the noise of life and hitting on something that's truly meaningful. We want to mention, in addition to sharing the info about these letters, you also offer coaching.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
I love to help. I do. So any of your viewers, the first 10 viewers that come to my website, debbieronka.com, I'll offer you a free 1 hour coaching session customized just for you.
Which is fantastic. Yeah. And honestly, this is, we're all kind of got to get in touch with not only one another, but ourselves as well, because we're all kind of feeling a little weird right now. And it's pretty good time to be able to kind of like take some sort of stock of what's going on in your life and to put your priorities in action. Debbie, it's great getting a chance to talk with you. And I know that these letters are probably a great fit for the teachers in our lives and the helpers in our lives as well. It really is some great
Thank
advice.
You,
and we appreciate you joining
You're
us
welcome.
Today. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me. And the family letter, it goes on and on. Thank
Certainly
you.
Does. And DebbieRonka.com, if you want to learn more about Debbie, you can also reach out to her on email. You see that arrow on your screen. Bestseller Publishing, a proud sponsor of The Morning Blend.